The human brain project for me is a big data management problem.
This is Professor Anastasia Ailamaki of the IC School at EPFL.
You have two sides, the experimental neuroscientists and the clinical neuroscientists.
And each has its specific challenges. Let's start with the experimental neuroscientists.
The experimental neuroscientists, including the life scientists here, collect data from experiments. And here you have a very significant part of their data that comes from simulations. Simulation data are data that come from computer programs that emulate neurons using meshes, and then model the interactions, the electrical interactions among neurons using equations, mathematical equations. And then they record what happens based on models that they have coded in order to make these neurons work with each other in similar ways as the human brain does.
So the experimental side of the human brain project is aiming at replicating the inner working of our brains. Evidently,
the higher the detail of the models, the better the results, the higher the quality of the scientific results. And we come in there helping people mitigate the effect of big data, which they get from their very detailed models, on the response time for their questions that are either posed directly to the simulation or posed by their visualization or analytical applications on the simulations.
But the human brain has hundreds of billions of neurons and millions of billions of synaptic connections between the neurons. Representing this would require already petabytes of data. But that's not all. There's also the matter of the spatial configuration of it all. Representing the entirety of brains could be a matter of zettabytes. Now that is big data.
These are spatial data, the data that correspond to items in space. So the work there for us is to find ways to navigate through space, which represent the human brain, in an efficient way, which both corresponds to the requirements of the application, but also to the speed requirements of the user or the demanding system.
Yes, because if the data is poorly organized, retrieving just one piece of information from the data could be a matter of minutes, if not hours, if not days. In other words, the way the data is stored and managed should depend on the way the data is structured and the way the data will be used.
And then we come up with indexing techniques, with query processing techniques, with exploration techniques, which we code in vertical computational stacks, and we make available to the neuroscientists so that they can do their work faster.
Wow. This sounds like a huge challenge already, and yet this was only the experimental side of neuroscience.
Now, on the other side, we have the data that come from clinical neuroscience, which are real patient data. Obviously, this data has a lot of information in it because they come from real cases. So in an ideal world, we would be able to combine all of this data together and along with the simulation data and retrieve really, really very useful information for how human brain diseases could be addressed.
Well, that's how things would work out in an ideal world.
In reality, however, this is a problem. Hospitals are busy places, right? You go and you ask the IT department for access to patient data, showing a piece of paper, you know, from the CEO of the hospital that allows you to do that. But the IT department isn't necessarily very happy to conform to that because they have a lot of other work to do.
Spending time and money to make the data available for research is usually not in hospitals' top priority lists.
But on the other hand, the promise from actually accessing all that data is so high that we go through the trouble to do it.
Yes, because quality data analysis of many hospitals' patients could pave the way to dramatic breakthroughs to cure many brain diseases.
Our team is helping medical researchers to generate biological disease signatures for diseases of the brain.
Wait, what's a disease signature?
Biological signatures are essentially unique IDs that identify a brain disease using the coupling of biological measurements and clinical measurements. And there can be only one such signature for every disease, for example, for every subcategory of Alzheimer's.
In other words, determining disease signature could revolutionize brain disease diagnostics.
To generate those, we need enough data. We need enough data from enough patients, from enough countries, from enough hospitals. And that's what we are out to do. We are out to go to the hospitals and tell the hospitals, look, we want to do this. We want to help generate those disease signatures, which are going to be very important for uniquely identifying the diseases and for efficiently treating them later on. But we need your help. So the hospitals put in our to our disposal a part of their data sets, which pertains to their brain disease patients. Information.
But then there are privacy concerns. You don't want the patient's names and disease to become public knowledge. That's why
we take the data set, we anonymize it right there in situ, in the hospital. No data ever leaves the hospital. And then we put in place our data management system, which allows to answer queries in situ without the data leaving the hospital.
But then the data from different hospitals should be aggregated to accumulate more data and allow for better understanding of brain diseases. That's why
we give the possibility to outside medical researchers to pose a question, say on a website, on a proxy, and the website breaks down, sends the question out to our nodes. We break down the question in pieces, send the relevant pieces to the hospitals, and get back the results.
Managing data in this way still guarantees privacy while allowing the extraction of crucial insights for neuroscience research. Now, this is still an ongoing endeavor.
We are at the process now of connecting the first 5 hospitals that we have collected MOUs from, and those hospitals are going to be the first federated network for achieving the first steps in this research target.
So hopefully in a few years, insights from the data will allow for breakthroughs for neuroscience researchers, which may lead to new cure to brain diseases. And when or if Nobel Prizes are one day awarded to the neuroscientists responsible for such breakthroughs, I hope you'll have somewhere in your mind a thought for Professor Ailamaki and other data scientists who paved the way to such breakthroughs by setting up a carefully thought database management system.
What we are proposing is to establish a radically new foundation to explore and understand the brain, its diseases, and to use that knowledge to build new computing technologies.
So we're going toward the more adaptive, less static, less predetermined, more post-deciding direction when building data management software.